20 billion years after the first crescendo of God's creative power, when all the morning stars sang together.
4.5 billion years after the formation of the planet Earth.
20 million years after the song of the great whales first sounded through ocean's depths. 1.5 million years after humans began to imitate God's shaping of creation.
18,000 years after drummers began to echo the heartbeat of the universe.
14,000 years after the caves at Lasso were decorated with paintings.
8,000 years after immigrants from Mongolia settled all the Americas. 2,000 years after Abraham and Sarah left Haran at God's command.
1,250 years after Moses led the people out of bondage to meet God at Mount Sinai.
749 years after the founding of Rome.
580 years after the Babylonian exile. In the 38th year of the reign of Octavian Augustus Caesar.
In the 33rd year of the reign of Herod the Great.
Jesus, the Messiah, Son of the Eternal God, conceived of the Holy Spirit, was born as one of us in Bethlehem of Judea, the child of the young maid Mary, watched over by Joseph, her husband. The birth of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace. God, Creator, Comforter, and Christ Child extends this welcome to you, no matter who you are, where you come from, or what you believe. You are loved and welcome here. Truly, it is love divine that gathers us across time and distance. Love guides us in practices of care during a season of pandemic. We wear face coverings, we maintain appropriate distance, and we stream worship. Friends worshiping online, you can download this evening's worship folder from the email you received or from oursaviorsmpls.org. Please set aside some bread or other sustenance for the sacrament of Holy Communion, the feast where Jesus meets us and nourishes us with grace. And you are welcome to light candles on your Advent wreaths at home or at the final carol of the evening. Friends worshiping in the sanctuary, you must promise me you will do your very best not to set your masks on fire. Truly, God meets us just as we are, right where we are. In joy, let us celebrate and sing with the angels.
Hark, the herald angels sing. truth of the Word made flesh, the cosmic love of the Creator, and the healing power of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Tender God, we marvel at your love come to earth, born among us in Jesus Christ. Stir us again to joyful faith, that with the shepherds we might rise and answer your call. In the name of Jesus, your love made flesh. Amen.
Amen.
Reading from Isaiah. The people who walked in deepest night have seen a brilliant dawn. Those who lived in a land of deep shadows, on them dawn has broken. For a child is born to us, an heir given to us, upon whose shoulders dominion will rest. This one shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Protector, Prince of Peace. This dominion and this peace will grow without end, with David's throne and realm sustained with justice and fairness, now and forever. The zeal of Yahweh Omnipotent will do this.
Christmas, 1973, a poem by Madeline Lynn. This is no time for a child to be born, with the earth betrayed by war and hate, and a comet slashing the sky to warn that time runs out and the sun burns late. That is no time for a child to be born, in a land in the crushing grip of Rome. Honor and truth were trampled by scorn, yet here did the Savior make his home. When is the time for love to be born? crystal on planet Earth, and by a comet the sky is torn. Yes, love still takes the risk of Earth.
that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace."
Into this climate of fear and apprehension, Christmas enters. Streaming lights of joy, ringing bells of hope, and singing carols of forgiveness high up in the bright air. The world is encouraged to come away from rancor. Come the way of friendship. At this holy instant, we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ into the great religions of the world. We jubilate the precious advent of trust. We shout with glorious tongues at the coming of hope. All the earth's tribes loosen their voice to celebrate the promise of peace.
Thank you. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. This is the good news.
Praise to God.
You may be seated. Friends, grace to you and peace from God, our Creator, maker of the sheep in the fields and the stars in the sky and all of us, and from Jesus Christ, our Savior, God with us. Amen.
Amen.
What can we do but wonder on this holy night? What can we do but marvel? Marvel that the one who birthed the cosmos, the one who sang creation into being, entered into this world with a cry, as each of us does, as a vulnerable baby, as Jesus Christ, to bring God's reign of peace and love to earth. Tonight we wonder at how Jesus came into a world that seemed to have no room for him. We read in our sacred story that there was no place in the inn for Mary and Joseph and newborn Jesus. And when I read this detail in Luke's account, I picture not the streets of Bethlehem, but I picture our own city streets. And I picture an experience many of us have had, going to La Natividad, hosted by Heart of the Beast and St. Paul's San Pablo's, when the holy couple goes up 15th Avenue looking for shelter. And house after house, they knock at the door and they are refused. They're turned away. The door is closed. There's no room for you here, they're told. But the story of Mary and Joseph and Jesus does not end with a closed door. And this is good news, friends. No amount of no's from the world, no amount of closed doors or lack of room, lack of compassion could stop God from being born. The world might say no to love. The world might say no to the proclamation of peace on earth. The world might say no to the dignity of some of our neighbors, all of whom are made in the image of God. But our God says yes. Yes to love, to peace, to the dignity of all people. And this is what we celebrate tonight. A God who says, when the world says no, yes. Here, now, it's here that I choose to be born. It's here that love takes on flesh. It's here that the lowly and forgotten of this earth learn the dignity of their divine worth and purpose. The door is closed, the inn is full. Well, then sing it in the fields. Let's sing it in the streets. Let the angel song ring out, glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth, peace. And this God still speaks. This God still whispers and cries and sings a yes for us to hear. This is good news for us because we live in a world that says in various ways, there's no room. Right now in Minnesota, heartbreak. divine love to be born in and among us. I see it in how you make room, when there is no room in busy schedules, to care for one another, to show tenderness to one another. I see it in how you organize for justice. Many of you on issues that might not affect you directly, but they sure do affect our fellow image of God-bearing community members who are facing closed doors of all kinds. I saw the Spirit making room for love to be born a couple of Sundays ago when we gathered outside for our 9 a.m. worship service and we discovered that the snowplow had pushed a big mountain of snow in front of the bread oven right in the place where we usually gather for worship. It seemed there was no room for worship that morning. But then what happened? Well, when the children arrived, they knew what to do. They climbed right up that snow mountain. They started digging and sledding and sliding. And God's love and peace and delight took flesh that morning. Oh, friends in Christ, what can we do but wonder on this holy night? And as we wonder, we are in good company. It's what Mary does on the night when Jesus was born. She ponders all these things in her heart. She doesn't sit there worrying about all the no's of the world. She marvels at Jesus and at these shepherd visitors and their vision of angels, their vision of peace on earth. Perhaps wondering and contemplation is one way that the Holy Spirit comes and makes room in us for love to be born and to take flesh in our minds and our bodies. Friends, truly in this cold pandemic winter, God looks upon us tonight and says, yes, here, now, here is where my love shall be born. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Joining our voices with the faithful throughout time and space, we pray for the church, the world, and all in need. Love proclaims that a Savior is born. Inspire us to be your church, embodying the good news of Jesus' birth to all who seek sanctuary, hope, and new life. Keep all our ministries vibrant and supported with generosity and joy. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Love cries to a warring world that the time for peace is at hand. Let weapons be laid down. Let fists unclench. Direct those in power to make decisions on behalf of the common good, to nurture and sustain all that is healthy, wise, and equitable. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Love sings through the wails of a newborn baby. Embrace all who cry out in pain, despair, or need throughout this holy night. Near to us we lift up Diane Rowe, Anton Moore, David Luke Pena, Mary Thoreau, and all those we hold in our hearts. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Love murmurs words of comfort to all children, to exhausted parents, to the overextended and the underemployed. Bless caregivers. Pour out your love upon families of every kind. Bring comfort to those for whom separation, grief, or loss makes this sacred season especially difficult. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Love whispers to a weary world that the time for rest and restoration has come. May all sleep in heavenly peace tonight, in safety and comfort. Then awaken us refreshed, ready to tend to your abundant creation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Rejoicing in your love that lives among us, we commend these prayers, confident of your grace made known to us in Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
Beloved, the peace of Christ, peace for all the earth, be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us share signs of peace with one another without sharing germs. Mary wrapped her baby in bands of cloth. God embraces us in everlasting love, that we might clothe and care for those who shiver in the cold. Friends, consider what portion of God's gifts you would like to return to support our shared ministry here at Our Savior's, whether given online, in the mail, or placed at the baptismal font, may God bless our offerings to the well-being of our readers. If you are worshiping online, now is the time to prepare your table for Holy Communion.
Jesus was born to an unwed mother. Glory.
gratitude, let us pray. God of promise and peace, we offer the gifts of our hearts and our lives to the service of all your creation. Lead us in this simple meal and nourish us with the grace and truth of Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Come, Lord Jesus.
Come, Lord Jesus.
your people. Bless this meal. Renew our lives. Bring the gift of peace on earth. And so your people plead, come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit.
Even now, in love, you draw near. And so we offer all honor and glory and praise to you, Holy One of Israel, incarnate Word, power of the Most High. Amen.
Amen.
Joining all the people of God throughout the ages, let us pray with confidence. Our Mother, our Father,
hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come.
Thank you.
strengthen you and keep you in God's grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. God most holy, God most lowly, you have come among us at this table. By the Spirit's power, form us to be bearers of your word, sharing gifts of mercy and grace with all. Through Jesus Christ, our host and our guest. Amen.
Amen.
Proclaim that God is with us. We who have fed on living.